Here's how I choose to use my smart stick. This is the way this works best for me. You can see here how I've drawn a line on the ground or put some tape on the ground. And what we've done in the studio here is run a piece of wood at an angle, probably about the lie angle of a 5-iron, up away from the ground. That's going to be important for both your takeaway and your follow-through. I like to call this end of the laser laser 1, this end laser 2. That's going to help me get the club back on plane. It'll help you do the same. So when I set up, to know that I'm tracing the correct sort of line, I'm going to point laser 1 at the line on the ground. I'll call that the plane line. I'm going to point laser 2 at my tummy here. As I start the club away from the ball, or from its starting position, I want to point laser 1 along the line, but at the same time as doing that, I think it's really important to point laser 2 still at the tummy. You see, if all you did was point at the line, you can cheat this, because you can clearly see there, yeah, laser 1's pointing at the line, okay, but that's not on a plane I'd want you to play golf with. So I think it's really important as you use the smart stick, laser 2 stays pointing at your tummy, as laser 1 stays pointing down at the ground. Now, as you keep swinging forward, swinging back here, at some point laser 2 starts to come down, and I think you can see that laser 2 is more or less coming down the line on the wall. Now, if you're just off a little bit, that's okay, and then laser 2 is going to come right along the line there, so that at the end of the backswing, laser 2 is more or less pointing somewhere along that line. Doesn't matter if you're a bit short, doesn't matter if you're a bit long. But from here, not too many slices, not too many pulls, not too many pushes, not too many hooks. Now I'm going to bring laser 2 back down that line. As I keep going forwards, I'm going to be pretty sure here that laser 2 is going up the wall. And eventually laser 1 is going to come back on the line, or very, very close to it. And now as I keep turning, laser 1 goes up the wall. I'd have to tell you that laser 1 going up the wall here is a big deal. That actually puts the turn of your body into the follow-through. Now, if you practice and you have laser 1 pointing where it should be, laser 2 pointing where it should be, and you have a sense of going up and down a wall here, most of your shots are going to go a lot more online.